rheumatoid arthritis, and that's the abbreviation for that is RA. And you notice I put the HCC on here. This is code 714.0 HCC of 38, and it has an RxHCC of 41. It says, what should a coder know about RA? Well, there's lots of things about RA that you should know, especially when you're doing HCC coding, since we've talked about it. You've got to be able to back up that the person has RA. Just with HCC coding, you can't, the doctor can't just list, you know, patient has RA. You have to be able to show that it's being treated, that he, you know, and once you have RA, you don't get rid of it. But it has to be shown that it's being treated. So what is RA? It's arthritis or polyarthritis, atrophic, rheumatic, or chronic. This is different than juvenile rheumatoid arthritis. Now, notice that use additional code to identify the manifestation. That's something to pay attention. Don't ever forget that. In this description about it, RA is really an autoimmune disease. It's usually affects the synovial lining of the joint, so that, you know, if you've ever heard of synovial fluid, like if a person has a bad knee or something, it swells up and they say they went and had it drained, had that synovial fluid, you know, pulled off of there. And in it comes in three stages. First, they'll have swelling and pain. They'll get like warmth. They'll be real hot and stiff around the joint. And then they start getting division of new cells and stuff. So it starts increasing and they start having problems. And you get the synovium, it starts to thicken. And that's when you start seeing people with their fingers getting real crooked and curled, and like their knuckles will get like bumps on them and stuff, and it can really you know, wreak havoc on your extremities, your hands and your feet, and your knees is what it works on. It gets into the cartilage. Let's scroll down just a little bit. Let's see. And pain is the main thing. You know, you've got a lot of pain, and sometimes that, and that's one of the treatments, is they're treating the pain. Let's see, the joint deformity, the instability of the joint too, and it gets to where you just can't, you know, you can't function, you can't move the joint because it's so stiffened and hardened. RA commonly begins in a small joint, so usually in the hands and in the wrist, and it usually happens, you know, bilaterally. So, you know, if you're doing it, you first know anything, it comes up on the other hand. It always affects both sides, both joints. There's other physical symptoms that you'll see. Now, when you're coding that means you want to look at the review of body systems that the doctor does, because he'll probably mention that. Look in the musculoskeletal section and scroll down just a little bit more. Is it the X-ray of that particular, that shows you the deformity. Look how those knuckles are going. Okay, you get pain mostly in the morning, stiffness, or if you've sat down for a long time, you can even run a fever, muscle aches and stuff, and make you feel like you've got the flu. Let's see, cartilage bone damage in the advanced stages, and you can imagine you saw that person's hand. The ligaments and stuff a lot of people realize this, but it can affect the lungs and the heart.
Alicia, we lost you a lot there, so I'm not quite sure for the last 30 seconds, we lost you there.
Okay, I'll back up. Not only can it affect the, give you flu-like symptoms and you can run a fever, but it also can affect your heart and your lungs. And most people don't realize that, but it will. And so if the doctor is taking special care with a person with RA and he mentions their lungs or he mentions their heart, that can be documentation to support the current RA condition. Now, RA usually happens in people between the age of 30 and 50, but it can affect children and men, and it more severely than women. I don't know why.
All right, so what can be done about rheumatoid arthritis? So a particular genetic marker in white blood cells, HLA, DR4, puts certain people at increased risk for RA. The immune system in people with RA mistakes the body's own healthy tissue for foreign invaders and attacks it. Some people also have an increase in rheumatoid factor antibody that helps direct the production of normal antibodies. It is also believed that RA may be triggered by an abnormal response to some kind of infection. I have heard that. Many researchers are in debate over whether RA is one disease or actually a complex of several different related diseases. And medications used: Humira, Enbrel, prednisone, Celebrex, methotrexate, Voltaren, and Gold. Ooh. So that's your little tidbit about rheumatoid arthritis.
Get more CPC exam tips, coding certification training, and CEU credits. Go to www.codingcertification.org.